2019 ist seiner unfassbaren Karriere des fünfmaligen Weltmeisters Barney Raymond van Barneveld. Achtelfinalgegner von Raymond van Barneveld ist am vergangenen Donnerstag 30 Jahre alt geworden. Er ist die Nummer 1 der Welt, steht bei 30 European Tour Titeln, der dreimalige Weltmeister MVG Mighty Mike Michael van Gerwen.
Left in the quarterfinal lineup this evening at the German Darts Open, and we have seen some wonderful stuff this afternoon, particularly from Dave Chisnell and just now from Nathan Aspen, who averaged almost 108 in beating James Wade. But in truth, this is the one we have all been waiting for, the daddy of Dutch darts, Raymond van Barneveld, going up against the man who has taken his crown as the King of Darts in the Netherlands, the man who was crowned once again the King of World Darts on New Year's Day, the three-time world champion Michael van Gerwen against the five-time world champ Raymond van Barneveld, who last time they met, after Michael van Gerwen had beaten him 7-1 in Rotterdam, announced he was done, putting his darts in a draw and never getting them out again. What he got?
Ladies and gentlemen, first leg is Raymond to throw first. Out. Game on.
Of a draw before this tournament. And he's played pretty well with them, Paul. We're not quite sure whether Raymond van Barneveld's long goodbye will end with a fairy tale finale or will just turn out to be a bit of a nightmare.
We'll have to stay tuned, everybody, to find out what happens next. But to this stage, he's beaten a Dutchman, a German, and a Dutchman. And in order to get through, he's got to beat another Dutchman.
120.
Quite the run.
Quite, yeah, and he's beating basically all the Dutchmen on the way up to Michael van Gerwen, isn't he? He's beaten the third highest ranked Dutch, taking himself out of the equation, the third highest ranked Jelle Klaassen, and then he beat the man who is between him and Michael van Gerwen, Jermaine Watermaener. Klaassen in qualifying, Watermaener in the tournament.
He took out the homeboy.
Yep.
That is Gabriel Clemens.
So now a match between him and Michael van Gerwen, and a match I'm pretty sure both men will relish.
Yeah, I agree with that. I think van Gerwen's got a bit of work to do today, because not only is he playing RVB, but his performance yesterday against Dimitri, he didn't have to play that well, so he's got to motivate himself today.
Well, not only didn't he have to play that well, he didn't play that well. Favourite finish this. Not going to go.
65.
We know that Barney will go for treble 20 here. He won't bother with the bullseye.
Old school. Necessary school. Very good start from the legend.
Yes, the old master, five-time world champion. This pair have had some incredible battles on the biggest stages of them all over the years. And Barney has won his fair share. Some of the meetings have been quite simply sensational.
And some of those games that they've had, Michael's produced some of his best stuff. He's produced 9 daughters against Raymond on more than one occasion.
Yeah, the World Championship semi-final for the 2017 tournament was remarkable. 109.34 Raymond van Barneveld average in that. He lost by 6-2. 58.
Barney Army out in force here in Saarbrücken. Seen quite a lot of these orange shirts around. He's very coordinated at the minute, isn't he, Raymond? Sometimes he's had a few fashion disasters, but this one is very popular.
Yeah, the Dutch camouflage shirts, and 95. There were a few quips that it was because he was disappearing from the darting stage. But Barney's back.
I think there's a country in the West Indies, isn't there, where you're not allowed to wear camouflage.
Well, I think you'll know more than me.
I think it's Jamaica. You're not allowed to wear camouflage in the streets because it's only the military that are allowed to do that.
Okay, it does have some make some sense now.
Darts in Jamaica. Imagine that, and then Barney wouldn't be allowed to wear his shirt.
How would it be police, though, Paul? Because, to be fair, you wouldn't be able to see a man wearing camouflage, would you? Barney might have a chance here. Does Van Gerwen take this out? 56. He hasn't, and Raymond van Barneveld returns, looking to break with a 2-darter in hand. Now he would love to find that treble again this time.
Double 11.
Surprise.
You left it, Ray. You should know what you're going for. Ooh, that's close.
62. We can't say it hampered him because he was fairly, very, very close, as you said, Paul. Unlike that. But that's in, and MVG has survived a little bit of a scare there early on in this match.
Get the feeling Michael's got to up the intensity a little bit. He's played Raymond many times, like you say, but Raymond's playing a very quick game at the minute. He's not playing deliberate. So I think every time you play Raymond over the course of a 15-year period, he's gone from quite like a proddy action to being quite deliberate. Now he's playing very fast. It's almost like playing a different opponent.
Yeah, and I've noticed in this match and the ones in this tournament so far that he's raced to the hockey, Raymond van Barneveld. I can't wait to release the darts.
It's almost like he's in the queue for Avengers Endgame. Because I know he's a super nerd. And I mean that in a very affectionate sense, everybody. Because he loves a bit of superhero action.
There have been times when Raymond van Barneveld has taken his time to approach hockey. Take a step back, as he put it in the particularly controversial Grand Slam match with James Wade a couple of years ago. He's taking extra concentration time for himself, where many would say he was trying to slow his opponent down. But I tell you what, Michael van Gerwen hardly performed yesterday. He hasn't performed in this arena very much, really. Been beaten by Ian White the last couple of years, and he's not playing that well here. Barney wants tops to lead 2-1.
Well, this would be typical van Gerwen. He left this to win against Dimitri last night, and he missed the ball. Not going to get that far this time. Seems to be a step behind Raymond at the minute.
It's not just the misses for Michael van Gerwen, it's the margin of them. Is he going to get away with it? No, because Barney pinned double 5, and I just want to come back to that point because I was at home enjoying an Easter egg watching the action last weekend, and in the match against Steve Lennon, I don't think I've seen Michael van Gerwen miss so many big segments as he did during that match. You can look at the figures and see that they haven't produced the greatest averages, but Mike, look at that from Michael van Gerwen, how far away it is from the treble 20.
59. Yeah, it's not the best sign for MVG fans at the minute. He's not played well in this tournament so far, and lo and behold, he's pulling his socks up. Watch out. 100. 180 coming in. A little bit of eagerness to get back to the hockey and put it right. That's better. 134. A little bit of green from the green machine. Well, the winner of this one's got to play Aspinall. good luck with that.
Yeah, and Aspinall's already handed out a towel into MVG on the Pro Tour this year.
I think there's a lot of experts within the game who are very large fans of Nathan. I am one of them. I think he's absolutely incredible. And he's refreshing as well. This is better from Michael. He's rescued this leg after a stuttery start, but he's got to take care of it. At tops. Now Raymond can steal.
It's exactly the same chance that he had earlier on. It's a long way off. Finds the treble again. He knows what he wants. Once again, the double 11 eludes him.
He rushed that one, Murph. 100% rushed it. Michael didn't rush that one. There's that intensity I was talking about. He has to break RVB in this match because he lost the ball. And maybe he's just starting to amp things up.
Well, they are playing at a similar standard here, the pair of them, but Raymond van Barneveld has twice missed double 11 for 84 checkouts, and had he converted them, he would have a 4-0 lead.
57. Well, Michael was very considerate earlier when I was commentating on the Gurney-Sulevic match, and he provided us with something called a commentary bomb.
125.
Right, you've got your photo bombs and your video bombs. Well, we've got commentary bombs, and that was provided to us by the Hulk of Darts, that is Michael van Gerwen.
Like the Mervyn King interview bomb.
Might have just started a trend with commentary bomb. Imagine if...
Let's hope not.
Imagine if that happened in football. Try and do that from the pitch to the gantry. Oh, that's better from MVG.
Yeah, but he's still not on a finish. And Barney, well, he might not be either. So this could be the chance to get that break that you just spoke about, Paul. 86.
Yeah, he's starting to pull the dart ever so slightly. So it's going to the left side of the bed. Another down there for a single.
433.
Leaves tops. And at some point, if we see the camera angle where we're straight onto the board, you'll see that the darts of Barneveld do kink to the right. So 80. If there is a tendency for a miss, it is to the left. Tops for van Gerwen. There it is. He's starting the motor, and he has got that valuable break.
Yep, needed to break. Has broken. Will it break Barney? Will it break Barney's belief? Because MVG certainly got belief now.
80.
First max of the match goes to Michael van Gerwen. And there you see the difference. Even though he only scored 97, it was all very tight, wasn't it, around the treble?
Yeah. There's that angle that we're talking about. You see the way that the darts fly.
100.
And that's not a brilliant example of it because they were actually quite straight. But the way that Michael's darts go in the water said dead straight 96. All the way through the air. But Raymond's, they go in from an angle and they kink at the very last minute. Look at that flight, just kicking to the right. So if he has a tendency that the barrel flicks to the left and he hits fives or sevens when he's going for 20s and 19s.
And Gerwen has the luxury of not having to use the 18 route for 128, so he can just tee up double 16 and tee up a chance to lead 4-2.
100, Mike Lubois, 32.
Last three legs have all been about Michael and how good he's been. This has been brilliant middle section from MVG. He's put his foot to the floor and Raymond couldn't live with it.
Yeah, he's upped his average from the late 80s to the late 90s in double quick time with two quick fire legs. And Barney's left languishing where they both were in the early part of the match.
99.
And that will be pleasing for MVG. There you see that brace of 13 dart legs. He's kicked in and kicked on. And Barney might look back on this match and think that he could have done a lot more damage in the early part of it.
100.
That's as good a ton as you will ever see. Three on a pinhead, but only one in the 60. And he really has upped the ante since last night, MVG. 100. Barney was troubled by Jameer Watamina last evening because he had the game in the palm of his hand to win 6-4, and then Watamina hit him hard in leg 10 after Barney missed a couple of darts for the match.
Yeah, he kept his head though, Raymond van Barneveld, which is very, very important, particularly for him. He could have finished it off early on, bust a finish, didn't he? He was going for double 4 and hit double 18.
Yeah, that's right, it was right in the corner.
He looked for 10, and now double 16. Does not want to give Michael van Gerwen a chance at this 1-4-4, but he has.
Surprised he likes double 16 with the way his dart lies. Couldn't see much of that. But he is going to come back for it. He's got to be aggressive.
128.
Can't afford to miss it on that low side again to make things awkward. That's a great shot.
Very conceivable that this could be the final meeting between this pair. I think
give over.
Many of us would hope not, because it is likely to that we will see Raymond van Barneveld in TV events. 100. Perhaps their paths will cross on the World Series.
Yeah, that's what I think.
At the European Championship. Who knows, Paul? Perhaps even at the World Championship.
Yeah, that would be some way to go out, wouldn't it? If that was a final or something like that. Even World Series finals, I think it's in Amsterdam this year, isn't it?
I think the thing is, at the World this time, everyone will know that it's Barney's last appearance. Right now, every tournament he plays, we're not sure whether it's his last appearance or not.
100.
Even at the World Championships, we're not sure.
Well, that
if he has a good season, he might do a U-turn.
Yeah, it's a good point.
He's already cried wolf once.
60.
Yeah, the boy who cried wolf. No one believes him, but with Raymond van Barneveld, it's whether he believes in himself. MVG opting not to go for the 164. He just wants to get the job done here. Doesn't want to become embroiled in a battle with Barney.
No way. Doesn't want any Barney Army supporters to get vocal. Wants to just get this done and keep them quiet. Double 16 in exactly the same spot for him. He's one away from a meeting with Nathan Aspinall, which is, oh, what can you say about that potential game?
Yeah, so just a reminder, this evening's quarterfinals. Gerwyn Price against Rob Cross, Adrian Lewis against Ian White, Dave Chisnell up against Menzo Suljevic, and then Nathan Aspinall against either Michael van Gerwen or Raymond van Barneveld. It's looking like the green machine. Some lineup, Paul.
Some lineup indeed. Nine, do not miss it. I'm not going to say what time it starts because I could get my times wrong this week.
Well, it's 7:15 local time, Paul. That's 6:15 in the UK. I'll do that bit for you. Provide the expertise on the darts.
Thanks, mate. Here comes Barney. There's a bit of a stare on that one. Bit of a glare. Little reset from Van Gerwen. Obviously, that dart didn't sit well in the hand. Didn't sit well that time either. But a great switch.
77.
That'll do.
Well, he could finish off the job here and now on the weekend of the World Snooker Championships with a 1-4-7 break.
His first 9 darter on TV was this shot, but he didn't go that way. And he did it against Barney.
Well, the 1-4-7-9 darter on the Euro Tour this year incorporated the bullseye for Michael van Gerwen. But Barney needs 1-1-4 to stay alive and kicking in this match. Double top. Ooh, just brushed the wire. But that could be the end for Raymond van Barneveld in this tournament.
That could be that. Ooh, he's still alive.
Well, he might want to swap suits with that guy in the crowd.
Left. Yeah, good shot.
Van Barneveld stealing the swag, but Michael van Gerwen has the darts to seal the deal here.
Oh, he's going to be up against it. Just goes to show how loud van Gerwen was there.
Well, before this leg, Barney would be thinking, whatever he hits, I need to at least match him.
140.
Couldn't quite manage it.
When your opponent gets a 180 to start, you need minimum 140. Two travels downstairs for van Gerwen. He is strangling the chances of Van Barneveld, and Van Barneveld is positively blue right now.
140.
4 out of 6 trebles for Raymond Van Barneveld in a leg he must win to stay alive. The problem for him is that Michael van Gerwen,
133,
has fired in 7 out of 9.
It's looking like an 11 or 12 darter for van Gerwen, and that means RVB needed a 9 in this one, and he ain't getting a 9, but he has put the pressure on.
Ooh, that's a flyer. Followed by another, and all of a sudden, Raymond Van Barneveld has a chance to force a final leg.
Do you believe, Ray? The crowd do. Do you? Oh, he believes all right. He's got the darts in the last leg.
Final leg.
We thought it was done. It isn't. Barneveld is still kicking. Listen to that crowd. The decibel level has gone off the scale in the last 10 seconds.
60.
Well, much has been made of this incredible record of Michael van Gerwen winning last leg deciders, around 20.
20 indeed.
In a row. So Barney having the darts might not be the advantage that many may think, because if anybody knows how to win a sudden death shootout, it's a man wearing green.
44.
Got the darts already. He's only thrown 3. Now, got to put himself in position and actually do it this time. He's mismatched darts. Great last dart from the world number one.
Barney needs to hit big. Hit hard. That will do, that will do. Keeps him interested in this leg. Is van Gerwen feeling the pinch a little?
Can't even finish.
All three darts dragged low by Michael van Gerwen. And all of a sudden, they're believing.
Sometimes it helps being one of the cool kids, doesn't it, Murph? Getting all that support.
MVG still holding all the aces. But
96.
Finds one treble.
That was an amazing treble 19. Where does he go from here? 18s. Brilliant.
Finds a treble. It's perfectly poised. 114 for MVG. If he can't find it, Barney gets a chance at 104. Double top. And Michael van Gerwen once again wins a sudden death shootout. Denies Raymond van Barneveld a famous win in his final year. It's MVG, the number one seed, who moves through to the quarterfinals. But Raymond van Barneveld made him work for it in the end. He will take on Nathan Aspinall tonight. But in the Dutch darting duel we all waited for, Michael van Gerwen is crown king.
Über Raymond van Barneveld. Interesting match, my goodness.
We were both struggling in the, with all the respect, we were both struggling in the beginning, and we both couldn't hit a normal 140, to be fair, and I was the lucky one to go 2 legs in front because I had one good leg, and after that I started missing double. I was thinking, come on, normally I always like the Euro2s, and I never won it before, so I want to do some damage here.
For the fans, for the viewers, these matches between you and Ray are very special. How was it for you? Is it special against the player who brought darts actually to the Netherlands?
Of course it's special. I don't like losing to Raymond, and he knows that. And I'm really glad I won this game. He's a phenomenal player. He did so much for darts, but yeah, it wasn't there for him today. I'm glad I hit a 114 finish. Was a good dart, and I think I also deserve to win this game. Yeah,
absolutely. Nathan Aspinall is the next one. He played his best average on stage, 108.
Yeah, that's good. But
I know.
I can do better.
See you later. Thank you very much. Michael van Gerwen. Der hat sich hier durchgekämpft. Er sagt, das war am Anfang nicht ganz so die Qualität im Spiel. Aber es ist immer was Besonderes.